Welcome back. I am the Welcome Traveler. I am super excited to be here with you. We are going to do our Fast 5 travel tips today. And this is more of just like a comparison and just my personal opinions. And a lot of times when people talk to me and they talk about accommodations, they always ask me the same question. Do you prefer a hotel, a condo, or a house? And so today I'm going to talk about just the pros and cons of them, and then at the end I'll tell you which ones we usually go for. Let's start off with hotels. Hotels are super popular. Whenever you think of vacations, most people think of a hotel. A hotel is really good because you have that 24-hour service, you have room service every day if you want, you have housekeeping every day, and you can even get breakfast, lunch, and dinner thrown into your hotel package. You have usually have pool facilities. If you book these type of hotels, you'll have spa facilities. You can do the steam room or the sauna, and that's what makes a hotel amazing. What makes a hotel, the cons of a hotel to me, are that you're sharing walls with someone. You can sometimes even be sharing all four of your walls if you don't have, all three of your walls if you don't have a balcony. And that could definitely be a con, especially if there are like young kids above you, and you know, on vacation, young kids are not going to bed anytime soon. They're too excited, and you hear the little pitter-patters of their feet as you're trying to sleep at 4 o'clock in the morning, or you hear them crying, or you hear your neighbors talking really loud next door. So that's really could be a con. Another con is just the price and the space that you get for a hotel room. For me, my hotels run anywhere from $75 to $200, and a lot of times the space that I get is just so much smaller than space that I'm used to. Another con with the hotels is no privacy. I wouldn't say no privacy, but there's a lack of privacy. It isn't as private as maybe having a home or having a condo, and that can definitely be a negative. Let's talk about condos. So condos are usually almost like little apartments. They're like nicer apartments, basically. And condos are really great if you a great budget option if you have a family. So if you have a family, if you're traveling with multiple people, condos are really good. They have their own kitchen, they have their own living space, so you get a lot more room. And the kitchen is just a really big thing because you can now cook your meals and you don't have to pay for outside food to come in or pay the exorbitant hotel prices for meals, because the hotels charge so much for their room service, and so much, which can be understood because it is a service. But in a condo, you could just skip all that. You really can control what goes in your food, especially if you're on a diet. Condos just really, really are nice. And if you get a really nice condo, like a nice area condo, a condo that's in a nice area or a nice community, you can also get the swim, the tennis, you can get the sauna and the steam room. And you can, that's just amazing, right? Some cons on the condos is, once again, you are sharing walls with people, and so they can be noisy. Sometimes, or a lot of times, when something is broken in a condo, it takes a lot more time for it to be fixed because you're dealing with a person or a company, and so that takes more time than it would have in a hotel because they have a whole staff dedicated just to maintenance or housekeeping. Another negative with the condo to me is, especially if you're staying in somebody else's condo, just I'm always afraid that something's going to break in the condo and then I'm going to be blamed for it when I did not do it. And I'll do a whole video on how to make sure you don't get blamed for things that were already broken in the condo or wherever you stay when you get there. But that's a whole nother video. So let's talk about a house. Renting a house is amazing, you all. So let's talk about a house. So you can rent a house anywhere from $75 a night all the way up. You know, it can go all the way up to thousands of dollars, just like hotel rooms and condos. But for us, when we rent houses, depending on where we are in the world, we go from $75 usually to about $200 a night. We usually don't try to go over that. And what's really great about a house is just privacy. You are not sharing any walls with anybody. It is private, and it is just private. The space that you get on the house is really good. The kitchen, you usually have a yard, and if you're really lucky, you can get one with the pool, and you can get one on the beach, and you can really pick where you want to be. That's what's good about a house. What's negative about a house is once again, if something breaks, you're dealing with a person and you're dealing with a company. Also, I notice with condos and houses, when you do have a complaint, you're talking directly to the owner, you're talking directly to the owner, sometimes they can be a little offended by it, so their response isn't as professional as it would be if it was a hotel. Because, you know, it's their condo, it's their house. They see it as something that they own, and sometimes they take it personal when you're saying something is not up to par or it's wrong with their condo or house. So that, I guess, is a negative. A positive is that, once again, space, and you can really pick your location. So when we are looking at condos and houses in Bali, the houses are actually a better deal because you end up getting staff, you get security, you can get a driver, and they'll go get your groceries for you. You just have to pay for the actual groceries, but they'll make it, you know, they'll make your food for you, and you'll get to pick exactly what you want made. And I think that's it. What's some positive and negatives that you feel makes a hotel better than a condo, better than a house, and vice versa? Leave a comment down below and tell me which one you prefer. Do you prefer a hotel, a condo, or a house? I'll see you all in the next Fast Five. Bye, y'all.